start to spread. Fancy gloves, though.
So if you've been listening to some of the bump music, keep Bobby going.
So there's never,
if you listen to some of the bump music here, right? We've been playing the Welcome to the Jungle, Girl School.
Theme from Rocky.
And we're talking about, so we say, what does this have to do with the whole Palo Verde high school thing?
Ooh, not good.
What is Mac the Knife about, the song?
Well,
it's about a hitman.
The gangster, yeah, the gangster and the hitman, and he's coming to get you, and there goes Mackie.
So according to the Valerie Cavazos 8-minute piece on K-Gun 9, it was represented over the weekend, there was a student that actually had a hit list going of who he was going to kill on campus, including the Tucson police officer that was stationed as the school resource officer.
T-E-D.
This is the chaos going on in your TUSD schools. Again, I will be fascinated. I'm sure it will be September. I can't wait to see the Tucson Chamber's endorsements on this one. When it comes, I pray to God it'll be the greatest radio ever when they push through something for Cam and Crystal. That would be gold, Jerry. As Kenny Banya said in Seinfeld, it's gold, Jerry, gold. So a lot of people have asked us this question of there's all of these obvious. Joe had to get going. He had to go to an event. He had to get going. So I excused him early from service. But all this stuff's going on at TUSD. But why is it only Cavazos seems to be covering this stuff? Because we have two other news stations. So I will ask you just again. These are just some possibilities why they're not jumping on it. If they start working on it, it's great. Because I see Matthew Schwartz is all over the place on people getting scammed by businesses in town. Of course, he's been great on the Pima County stuff, some of the city of Tucson and bad roads and, you know, losing the front end of your truck on a pothole on Silverbell. He's there. I got it. But you never see that much about TUSD on either of those.
I see a lot about the kitchen cops.
Right.
Thanks.
KVOI is all over kitchen cops. Yeah. Absolutely. And I'm okay with that. I want to know who has cockroaches climbing around their kitchens. But, so one possibility on KVOI, and if they want to argue with me, there sure is that their former executive producer, Stephanie Bowe, is now the TUSD PR director. All right? She's the Minister of Information for H.T. Sanchez. And remember, they got a $750,000 marketing contract from TUSD. So you'll see ads about, hey, come to one of our schools where maybe your kid could get knifed, right? That's a part of a $750,000 marketing contract between TUSD and KVOA.
That's a lot of money.
So I don't know if that would, hopefully that would not influence news decisions. I pray it doesn't, but it's something to keep an eyeball at. Alexis seems to cover some stuff that goes on, but she doesn't seem to cover some of this. Sometimes she does and sometimes she doesn't. Sometimes Stellar sticks his head out and will bang on them like he did with the 1-2-3 monies that just happened in the last couple of weeks. And also how they do the DSEG. Alexis did run one story about the when the investigators on the DSEG case came in and they got to the classroom that had no teacher. I think that was an Alexis story. The other thing that has been suggested to me about the absence of KOLD in the TUSD, and I know recently I think he just left there, but it sounds like we all know J.D. Wallace, the investigative reporter at KOLD. Mm-hmm. I think he's gone now. I think he might have recently left. Hmm. But one of the things you should look at is the Director of Staff Services to the Governing Board at TUSD is a lady named Mary Alice Wallace. I think it's JD's mom.
Really?
So I don't think he's there anymore, but I think it's just recently JD left. But that has been suggested to me. That's another thing to look at on why KOLD doesn't jump too far into the TUSD thing, is I believe that's JD's mom is the Director of Staff Services for the Governing Board. So just a couple of things to look at there. So, again, KVOA got $750,000. Who buys $750,000 of advertising anywhere in this? Other than maybe the Jim Click. You know what I mean? I mean, HT has been really pushing on the $5,000 to join the chamber right before they endorse Adelita Grijalva. So either that's a bad move that looks dirty, or they're stupid enough to say, oh, we're going to do it right before an election. How about do it 6 months later? That doesn't look so obvious. So this is what's going on at TUSD. They're going to try to get their best to get Crystal and Cam reelected. There are people running for office who are not them, including Dr. Mark Stegman running for reelection. We have Betts Putnam. She came to our happy hour last Wednesday. We have Lori Regal was here, and then Brett Rustan was here, and I think there's one other lady, Sedgwick or something. So you have options that are not these two. But they're going to do full court press. You might see some out of area union money going to Cam and Crystal. Go over to Adelita's campaign finance from a couple of years ago. You'll see money from, I think, $5,000 from the Mesa Firefighters Union. I don't even know how that works in relation to sloshing the union money around. You'll see lobbyists and nonprofits from the Washington, D.C. area that work with her dad sending money to influence a TUSD school board election to help Adelita. So very fascinating over there. And I wish that all of these people that we talked about, and like the Star, they would go after stories like TUSD, half of what they do trying to get Allie Miller, and you might have yourself a little better community in relation to education at the Tucson's largest school district.